What we struggle with here on this planet is actually a cosmic conspiracy. It goes beyond the conspiracies of the elites here. As a matter of fact, the elites are part of the cosmic conspiracy, but they're lower part. There's higher layers to it. In a nutshell, the cosmic conspiracy involves using the sun as a weapon, as a way and means to depopulate this planet. There is a way, by those who know how to do it, to trigger a massive explosion on the sun and direct it towards the planet. We call this a coronal mass ejection. When it directly strikes this planet, a very large one, a class 5, C5, what it will do is will knock out the satellites. It will also most likely cause an electromagnetic pulse, a low frequency pulse, that will fry a lot of the transformers and Delic electronics on the planet, knock out the power grids. This will then create a domino effect. I've also said there is inside the banks there has been some programming set up by some saboteurs to snarl all the interactions, whatever interactions are still functioning, so that commerce, world trade, commerce distribution is completely snarled, logjam, nothing is moving. So a combination of these factors is part of the cosmic conspiracy. Now, the higher-ups, which are off-planet entities who want to depopulate this planet, they're the ones taking care of the solar situation. The elites on this planet, call them what you want, the Illuminati, they're actually in contact with these higher-ups, these extraterrestrials. They have been for a long time. And they know what their plans are. They know what's happening. And they have literally set up the planet to fail with all these satellites, with the trading system being completely dependent on algorithms and computer technology and software programs that can be hacked, with massive seed conglomerates trying to control as many seeds in the world as possible, so that when the crash happens, that farmers will not have enough seeds to plant. You see, most of the localized seed banks around the world are no longer there. We're depending on these massive conglomerate seed companies to distribute seeds at exactly the right time all over the world. That will become completely snarled, and it won't be happening, and so farmers simply won't have the seeds. All of this has been set up by the elites to bring about depopulation. They're doing their job here. The extraterrestrials are working on triggering the solar explosion, and all this is being coordinated. Now, if you had any idea of the amount of underground facilities that have been built, you would simply be astonished. We all would be astonished at this. It's way more than we suspect. It's way more extensive. We're not talking about some little concrete bunkers. We are talking about massive towns and even cities underground that have already been set up. There's a tremendous amount of money. If you ask yourself, where has all this money gone? There's so much money, it seems to have disappeared, right? What happened to it all? It's been channeled into these massive construction efforts that the elites have been undertaking for quite some time now. And there's huge underground facilities. Why? Because when all of this, the crash happens and everything gets snarled and civilization begins to collapse into anarchy and famine and starvation and plagues and all of that, the elites will disappear into their underground facilities. They've been warned ahead of time. They've planned. They know that all of this is going to happen, and so they will just very quickly disappear from the surface of the planet and be living very comfortably underground. And we think, wow, is that possible? Well, I'll tell you this. You know how we're looking for extraterrestrial life? SETI is search scanning, you know. We're searching, is there any life out there? We're looking in the wrong place. Most life on other planets is underground. Okay. Very, very few are surface dwellers. Most dwell underground. It's safer. because it protects from solar events, it protects from tsunamis, earthquakes, it protects from a lot of things, a lot of problems. So the technology to live underground is extremely advanced. Most of the extraterrestrials have been visiting this planet. They live underground. They live in bases under the ocean. They live under lakes, inside mountains, under the surface. That's their technology. That's what they're completely used to. It's surface dwelling, which to them is extremely strange and very, very dangerous because of the problems that can happen with the sun. And they have been through in other epochs and times, battles and wars in the heavens, using the stars as weapons aimed at other planets. So they have been through this, and they know that being underground protects from that. So the elites who have set up, who have rigged this world to collapse, made it very vulnerable, okay, to a coronal mass ejection, extremely vulnerable. They've been rewarded by building these underground facilities, and they feel that they're going to survive these times. And then once the mayhem on the surface is over, they will come back out and set up their fiefdoms and principalities and kingdoms here in this world. And the remaining people here will be their serfs and servants. Now, why do various entities want to depopulate this planet? Very simple. They want to use the planet for their own purposes. They have their own agendas. And they see this planet as being destroyed by humanity. They're wiping out the resources. They're destroying the ecosystems. They don't want that. They have a purpose in mind for this planet. Humanity is obstructing this purpose. So they have decided to do the trigger of the kill shot, the coronal mass ejection. Now, if we had a simpler society, no technology, none of that, it wouldn't work. I tell you, it would not work. It's only because this high technology has been brought in that it'll work. And I tell you another thing, this high technology was brought in intentionally to rig this planet so it could be collapsed. That was actually the purpose of it. Like for me, I would never have used any of this stuff, never would have developed it at all. I'd be back in the 19th century with trains mostly. No satellites, okay, no computers, no algorithm, none of this, because then a coronal mass ejection class 5 would have very minimal effect on the planet, wouldn't cause hardly any problems at all, wouldn't be vulnerable to it, I'd have local seed banks everywhere. Every community would have their own seed banks, local seeds. None of this would happen, but it was the invasion, as I say, of these saboteurs into this planet who have set it up, have rigged it to collapse. It's literally what has happened. Now, the elites are not the only ones who are going to escape. Those who are aligned with spirit and can see what's taking place and know what's taking place, they have prepped in a spiritual manner. And there are different factions have different ideas about escaping. The Christians say that they're going to be raptured off the planet. That may very well take place. New Agers say they're going to raise their vibrations and ascend into a higher dimension. That also may very well take place. There are some that have these stargates or portals or vortexes or something, and they feel that they'll be able to go through those into other dimensions of beingness. And that too may take place. There are some who believe that extraterrestrials, beneficial ones, will come and lift them off of the planet. That may too also take place. And there's a variety of options that may very well take place for those who have foreseen this coming. They know, they were warned, and there's been a lot of warnings. I know for a fact the Bible has warned about this for those who can interpret it very clearly. There's been other different types of warnings taking place for a long time. The warnings are increasing now. The clarity about it all is increasing. The dots are being connected. It's an open secret at this point what's going on. Once again, in a nutshell, internal sabotage on several of the world's major banks intentionally trigger coronal mass ejection, wiping out the satellites and electrical grids and sensitive high-tech instrumentation and equipment, leading to a complete collapse of all trading and all distribution. Becomes totally snarled. Nothing is moving in the world at all as far as distribution. An inability to get the seeds to plant crops for the next year. Complete lack of food. severe famine and starvation, and then wars, looting, rioting, martial law, all of those things, mayhem, chaos on the planet's surface, the elites disappearing into underground bunkers, the spiritually prepared ascending off of the planet in some way, and that is the scenario that is right in front of us at this point. And the joker in the deck, and there always is one, is the galactic superwave that is set to arrive here very soon as well, which will throw a monkey wrench into the plans of those who want to take over this planet and the elites underground. They will find it is not what they bargained for. And the fact is, if you know cosmic history, you know this is just business as usual. This is what always is taking place. It's a cosmic soap opera, really, this universe. All this Sturm und Drang, this drama, it's always playing out like this, really on an epic scale is what we're seeing now. We're just not used to it here. We've got this nice little idyllic place, seemingly, this planet that's sort of separated and isolated on the fringes of the galaxy, and we think that we've avoided all of this drama, epic drama, but no, it's finding its way to us right now, and so that's why we're feeling uncomfortable. We say, wow, this is drama on a much bigger scale than we're used to. And yes, it is. But if you have cosmic memory, which you really do, you can tune into that and you know, this is just business as usual in the universe. So you're not so impressed by it. And you say, I'll sidestep this. Thank you. Thanks, but no thanks. And I know we've been trained and indoctrinated to think technology is such a wonderful thing, but I never bought into that at all. I smelled the rat from the very beginning. But just look at the people, the leaders of high technology, and just ask yourself, do you really feel comfortable with them in charge of your destiny, these people? I've lived in the heart of Silicon Valley my entire life. So I see all these people and all these people, and you look at them and you say, I don't want them in charge of my destiny. Are you kidding me? They're idiot savants. You know, they don't have any wisdom. And so now the facts are finally coming to light, what they really were about in the first place. And that is, they've booby-trapped the planet. They've rigged it so it's totally vulnerable to a coronal mass ejection and sabotage within the computer systems of the banks. They've rigged it all, set it all up so it can collapse. That's what they've actually been done. That's their whole purpose. And now I believe you look at these great so-called leaders of technology in a different light. There's always been something about them, right? Kind of secretive and furtive. And you say, you know, there's something going on here that just doesn't quite add up, so to speak. What's their agenda, really? Now you know what their agenda really is, has been from the very beginning. They're kind of like the Wizard of Oz. You know, you pull the curtain back and you realize, oh my gosh. Just look at this little person there, Wizard of Oz, with all these levers trying to be so great. But now we find out all this great stuff that we supposedly have. You know, it was all a setup from the very beginning. But the good news is that it's been seen through. You can see through it. You're hearing it right now. And you will process this gradually. First, you might have the knee-jerk reactions will come, for sure. But you hear it, and you start processing it, and you say, you know, intuitively you say, aha. There's a little aha in there, a little smile saying, aha, I'm onto them. I'm onto the situation now. And that's a good feeling, and you realize in your heart, I'm going to be okay. This wisdom can spread out. This clarity can spread out. I'm part of a process of clarification. You know the song, we won't get fooled again. You know what? We did get fooled again entirely. Most of the world did. Some did not. Some did not get fooled again. And that feeling is now, we didn't get fooled again. We saw through it. It wasn't easy. It was very difficult. But we've done it, and it's becoming greater and greater and greater and greater clarity. So it's actually, that's as far as your destiny goes, that's a tremendous, tremendous, wonderful thing. And don't be afraid of a simpler lifestyle without high technology, because I tell you, it's vastly superior, because you'll be able to spend quality time focusing on the deeper questions as to why spirit is afraid to choose a new idea. And you'll be able to go through item by item, carefully looking, and see all those fears are unfounded. They're all based on simply plausibility, that's false. And when you're able to spend the time, quality time, year after year after year, in a quiet world where you don't have, you're not so frantically busy, you're able to overcome your fears, and you see there's nothing to be afraid of to choose a new idea. It's perfectly okay, because mind isn't crazy. Mind isn't non-functional. Mind's actually still flawlessly functioning. So it's a great benefit in the future to be in a non-technological world, place, very quiet place. Don't be afraid of that. I guarantee you the quality time that you will spend there is so vastly superior to the time that we're spending in today's world that you can't even compare it. Just be able to sit quietly with some teachers or clarifying in a very serene, still environment, and to spend quality time entirely focused on the very important question about your fixation on existence, on this one idea, and your capacity to choose a new idea. To do that is incomparably superior to the kind of frivolous lifestyle that we're used to right now on this planet, with all this high technology providing very frivolous distractions, trifles. You will be so grateful and happy to be in a better situation. I guarantee that. And there will be teachers in those situations also, who simply trainers to motivate you. Say, you can do it. You can do it. Come on, every day, work at it, work at it. And you will work at it. And you will enjoy the process of clarifying and seeing through the delusions of existence and all the fears that did turn out to be false fears. You'll enjoy that greatly. So don't fear your destiny at all in seeing through this great cosmic conspiracy and seeing through it. Don't be afraid that somehow you're going to be left behind. No. You are going to go into a place that's very, very wonderful opportunities for you. Great destiny. And you will actually eventually choose a new idea and move on from the chaos and the drama of existence and find yourself in unbelievably rich experiencing, which is your birthright, your inheritance, and your true destiny. So, much clarity to all of you always. That's it.